morning and a warm welcome to English class students. So last time, in last video, you have learnt about at the science fair. So today we are going to continue the lesson at the science fair. So last time in English, you have learnt how a science fair is planned, organized, conducted, and what is meant by graphic presentation and even oral presentation. So today we will proceed further with the next part of the lesson. At last, the big day arrived. The fair was inaugurated by the oldest science teacher, Mr. Gizar. It was Mr. Gizar who had come up with the idea of a science fair some 25 years ago. Initially, it was meant for just one class, but the idea had become so popular that now the entire school participated in it. Now here, students, in this paragraph, it has been mentioned that there was one teacher, ex-teacher, whose name is Mr. Gizar, and he was the science teacher. He was the oldest science teacher in the school, and he was the only one who had started the science fair around 25 years ago. So he was also invited here for the science fair. And initially, when he had done, he had done only for one class. But this, since the idea of the science fair became very popular, it is now run in the entire school, or the whole school is participating in it. Mr. Gizar explained the importance of using the scientific method to find the answers to the questions relating to the physical world around us. He was happy to see the stalls, especially the ones that showed simple methods of identifying food adulteration. He appreciated the fact that in most of the stalls, visitors could also try out the various science experiments and models. He gave a special pat on the back to the clean brigade. The brigade members made rounds of the fair, spreading the message of cleanliness. But that was not all. Now here, you are going to learn about how the science fair is organized, using the scientific method. So even Mr. Gizar explained the importance of using scientific method to find out certain questions, to find out the answers to the questions which are related to, you know, the world around us, physical world. Physical world means the world in which we are living. So when we have to have the scientific attitude in us, we need to learn about the scientific method. So here also he mentioned about the importance of scientific method. And he was also happy to see the stalls, especially the ones that showed simple methods of identifying food adulteration. Now, what is meant by food adulteration, or what is meant by adulteration? Adulteration is nothing but, you can note down the meaning of this, making a food or drink less pure by adding another substance. Making a food or drink less pure by adding another substance. That means, you know, whatever you get in the market may not be pure. That means there might be some impurities added to the food which you are eating or getting. Like for example, you may get in tea powder, you may get, this iron filings may be mixed in that, okay? Then some seeds like, sesame seeds, in that seeds, some other seeds might be added. And so the food becomes adulterated, or food becomes impure. That means whatever nutrition we are supposed to get from that food, we may not get the nutrition. Why? Because it has been made impure. And why it is made impure? It's just some people wants to make profit, wants to make money. so that while after adding all these substances to the food, you know, the quantity of that food increases. Okay, so that is why, you know, due to some corrupt people, you know, the food is adulterated, and such food if we eat now, then we may have some problems. So Mr. Gizzard was so happy to see, you know, these stalls who had displayed or who had shown certain simple methods of identifying the food adulteration, so that we can also come to know that which food is adulterated or which food has been made pure. There are certain methods, okay, in science also experiments are there to find out how the food, you know, can be tested whether it is pure or whether it is adulterated. So here Mr. Gizzard was so happy to see this, that, you know, students were showing how we can identify the food adulteration. He appreciated the fact that in most of the stalls, visitors could also try out the various science experiments and models. As I mentioned to you yesterday, that there were some models, like working models were there, stationary models were there, okay? So he was also happy to see some students have already displayed certain experiments which they were doing there, live experiments they were conducting. And even certain models, they were able to, you know, explain to the people very well. He gave a special pat on the back to the clean brigade. Now here the clean brigade means it has been pointed to those students who were, you know, who were given the duty of keeping the area where the stalls were put out, where the fair was conducted. They were supposed to clean that. So here brigade is actually a word which is used in army, okay? But here it's like a battalion, okay? In army you have battalion, right? So here also these students were like battalion, and they were, you know, going and cleaning the whole area, whatever. Suppose there are some science experiments conducted live there, there will be so much of litter around, right? So to clean that litter, there were some students who were given this duty of cleaning the area. Okay, so he gave a special pet. Okay, what is the meaning of a special pet? A special pet is nothing but an idiom. Pat on the back is an idiom, and it means that to praise someone, or praise or approval for something which is well done. You know, patting on the back, we say, you know, give a pat, shabbas ki we say. So that is called as pat on the back. So he had appreciated, or he had praised them, those who were involved in doing this cleaning work. So he gave a special pat on the back to the clean brigade. The brigade members made rounds of the fair, spreading the message of cleanliness. So they were not only cleaning, but even they were spreading the message of keeping the place clean. But that was not all. They had vowed to keep the school clean. Okay, they have vowed to keep means not only cleaning, they had made a solemn promise to them. Okay, they have made that promise that they are going to keep the school very clean. Okay, so they had vowed. Vowed means a solemn promise. Okay, they had made a promise to themselves to keep the school neat and tidy. They had vowed to keep the school premises spick and span. Spick and span means clean and tidy during the fair. Though they expected more than 1,000 visitors and half as many stall holders, they were a disciplined lot. But what with so many activities and experiments going on, it was bound to create a lot of litter. Okay, now the fair was arranged in such a manner that, you know, 1,000 and more than 1,000 people could visit that, visit the place. And even, you know, some students were doing in live all the experiments. Okay, they were showing to the people, you know, there will be lot of litter, right? So it was created, it was bound to means it was almost certain to make the litter. Litter means what? Kachara. Okay, lot of kachara around, that is called a littering around or litter. Okay, so it was bound to create a lot of litter. They were well equipped with garbage cans. Now, since you know they knew that all these things are going to happen, that the people are going to come, many thousand, more than thousand visitors were there, and even you know 56 stalls were there, and each of these stalls would create a lot of litter. So this clean brigade, what they were doing, they were well equipped. That means they were having lot of things with them, like for example garbage cans were there, scoops is like a dustpan which is used to you know gather the collect the litter and then put it into the cans and all. So that is also called a dustpan, scoop. Okay, brooms were there, then wipe like mopping the floor, they require wiping for you know wiping cloths. So like that, everything, they were well equipped with all these things. That is the clean brigade. Now let us proceed a little further. Let us also take a round of the fair to see some of the highlights. The 6th standard children were handling the following stalls. So you know that the whole school had participated, but this you know pictures are only of the 6th standard students, what they had done. Like for example, you might be knowing in 6th standard, since you all are 6th standard students only, you know that what is the portion in your science textbook, right? Like for example, kinetic energy is there, about science energy lesson is there, then in energy you have learnt about mechanical energy, types of mechanical energy are kinetic and potential energy, right? Sound lesson, then you have learnt about electrostatic energy. Okay, all these topics are included in your science textbook, right? So 6th standard students, what type of stalls they had put? They had put, the first one was use of kinetic energy, how kinetic energy can be used to generate electricity. So you can see a stall over here which has displayed the model of a water mill, how using the water we can generate electricity. Then use of potential energy, a plastic bottle, motor boat. Some of you might have also done this experiment to make a water motor boat, how it you know floats in the water and just moves, just because of the energy called as potential energy, which has been stored in that plastic bottle. Fine. Then sound, this is a very simple experiment. You might have also done this at home, that is taking the two cups and making the holes in that and passing a thread through that and then just saying from one side hello, the other person can hear that sound. So this was a very simple experiment of sound. So everyone enjoyed making simple string telephones at this stall and then using them. Right now, students, so this is a very simple type of a telephone wherein you can hear the other person talking from the other side. Okay, like two cups, one cup you need to hold it near your ear and the other cup you need to keep it near your mouth so that you can, whatever you speak will be heard by the other person. Okay, so this is a simple experiment of sound. Then you know about this electrostatic energy, you know, no, static electricity, that when you rub the balloon on your dry hair, then it gets charged, and if you just take it near the pieces of the paper, you will see that all the pieces of the paper will be sticking to that balloon. So there was a fun here. Why? Because you know when they were doing all these things, all the balloons used to get bursted out, right? So this stall was so popular that additional help was needed to blow balloons. Okay, you can understand, you can imagine that when they were doing all this, they were playing with the balloons almost. That means so many balloons must have got wasted there, must have burst out there, right? And it must have also created a lot of litter. But many students used to come and enjoy there because it gives also sound, right, of bursting of the balloons, right? Yes. Okay, the next was food adulteration. As I've mentioned to you, what is adulteration? It is not just making the food substances impure, okay, by adding some other substances which is having the similar color or similar shape that is added to the food. So food adulteration, even the parents learned something at this stall. That means even parents came to know how we can identify whether the given food substance is pure or adulterated. They also learned there. Okay, student. Now next, fun with the magnets. Okay, fun in the magnets, you know magnets, there are different types of magnets. So some children have even displayed the different types of magnets. So people came to visitors, queued up to see the different types of magnets at the work. I mean, those who didn't know what different types of magnets are there, queued up means what? They were standing in a queue or they were standing in a line to just observe or to watch all these magnets. Okay, so these were around six stalls, and there was one more, that is maintaining machines. I'll just read out this paragraph and then I'll explain to you. Some of the visitors made video clips of the presentation at this stall. It consisted of different children playing the roles of different machines, all crying out turn by time, "Hey, we too need your attention. We can serve you well only if you take care of us." Machines, we have so many machines in our homes, like for example, a cycle will be there, sewing machine is there, maybe your motorcycle is there. All these machines are there at home and we need to maintain them. We need to maintain them means what? We need to take care of them. Why? Because we need to, use it for a longer time. If you do not maintain them, what will happen? They'll get spoiled faster. So here, some of the children were, mimicking some of the machines, and they were saying that here, we too need your attention. That means we also require some maintenance, or we need to also keep it well, okay? Otherwise, we will also get spoiled, and then you won't be able to go wherever you want, or maybe you will not be able to do certain work, right? So they were also crying out here, okay? These children were in the form of machines, and they were just explaining the importance of maintaining the machines. Okay, students, now next paragraph we'll go to. The fair was such a huge success that the school had to run it for 3 days instead of two. Okay, earlier it was decided that the fair will be only for 2 days. But since it was a huge success here, it was run for almost 3 days. Principal allowed this change in the timetable only because it was a truly educational activity, not just for the children, but also for their family and the entire community. Okay, so why it was successful? Why? Because it was a truly an educational activity, so that not only the children got benefited, but even their parents also got benefited. They came to know so many things like adulteration of the food and all, right? So that is why, it was postponed it was for one more day. Okay, one more day was included. That is, from 2 days it was for 3 days now made, and principal had allowed all these changes in the timetable. No wonder everyone is already looking forward to the next year's fair, because they were so happy to conduct this fair that they were already now looking forward for the next year's. Right, children? So this is regarding the lesson. Now let us try to learn the scientific method. Scientific method means, there is a procedure for, any experiment. So what you need to do in an experiment and how you are going to find out the questions, for that you need to know certain steps. So suppose if you have to find out certain answers to certain questions, you need to first, ask yourself or observe. Okay, the first step in scientific method is always observe what is around you. See, student, there is a difference between seeing and observing. Seeing means you just have a glance and then you go proceed further. Quick look you have. Observing means what? Looking into the whatever is there very minutely and finding out the details. That is called as observing. So whenever you want to conduct some experiments, you might be also seeing so many things around yourself. Like for example, the litter falling down every day from the plants, leaves are falling down from the plants. So have you ever wondered all these leaves where they are going? Correct? So that you have to observe. Okay, so like that you can observe so many things in nature. So let's see what are the different steps and how you can conduct an experiment and how you can find out answers. So first step is observe what is around you. Now here an example is given that this person or this student is watching a magnet of the fridge door. Okay, you know that when you open the door, you don't have to shut the fridge door very tightly. It automatically goes and, closes. You might have observed this, right? Now why does this happen? So what you have to do, second step is ask questions. First is observe what is around you, fridge, fine? Now ask questions. Like why, or why not, and how. this type of questions when you ask, you will automatically try to find out the answer. Like for example, this example we'll take now. Ask questions. Why not, and how? So here the question is, why does a fridge magnet stick to the fridge door but not to the kitchen platform? Right now, it is sticking to the fridge door, but is it sticking to the kitchen platform? No. The answer will be no. But then, why to the fridge door only? Okay, now, next question. Next step is, can you think of an explanation here? So this is what is called as hypothesis in the scientific method. Now what is meant by hypothesis? Hypothesis is just guesses, some of the guesses and some guess you have to make, or some ideas that will not have any base or that are not based on certain knowledge. Okay, so you need to hypothesize. Okay, a hypothesis means you just have to guess some reason or guess or ideas that are not based on certain knowledge. Okay, so can you think of an explanation here? Yes, I will try to stick it to maybe it has some special powers and that is why the fridge is going and shutting the door of the fridge door, right? So maybe because it has some special powers. Now, so what you need to do now, you need to find out the answer to this, right? Why only fridge door and not the kitchen floor? Now you need to set up an experiment and to try out your hypothesis, that just to find out whether it is really having some power or something else. Okay, now I will try to stick it to different things. Okay, what do you have to do? You have to stick it to different things. Maybe a wall, a tile, a potato, a wooden table, pots and pans, a plastic bottle, a cup, or maybe some steel vessels, some iron vessels, right? So all these things you will try to stick the whatever is there for the fridge door, right? Now once you try to stick it to all these things, what you need to do now is, the next step is record your observation. That means whatever you have observed, whether it is sticking or whether it is not sticking. So this will generate your data. Like for example, the magnet sticks to some surfaces but not to others. Okay, so you can see that it might be sticking to some iron article, so maybe the steel vessel, but not to a plastic bottle, a wooden table, or maybe a tile or a potato, right? So that means a magnet sticks to only some surfaces but not to others. So from this, what we are getting, we need to draw some conclusion. That means final answer we have to write. Do they match your hypothesis? If yes, why? And if not, why not? So do it has some power? Yes, it has some power, and that power is nothing but the magnetic power, right? So the conclusion will be, it seems as if some metal objects are attracted to the magnet, they are made of iron or steel. Okay, so here you can see that there were so many things used for making this, doing this experiment, and out of that only few of the metals were attracted to the magnet. And out of them, which metals were especially attracted? One is iron and second is steel, which is an alloy of iron. Right, so it did not stick to any other substance. So finally what you would say, write down your findings and share them with others. So what were your findings? Now you can say now finally that is you can conclude finally that magnet attracts iron, but not all substances and not even all metals. So what is your conclusion? Magnet attracts iron, but not all substances and not even all metals. Now that means, what is the answer of your fridge door? Yes, because the fridge door may be having the iron strip, and that is why the magnet which is coming, which is there for the door, is getting stuck to the fridge, right? So it's because there is an iron strip, right? So this is how a scientific method is designed. That is, what you need to do is that first you need to observe, then ask questions, then you can think of an explanation. That is hypothesis you have to put up. Then you, on the basis of your hypothesis, you need to set up an experiment, then you need to record your observations, then from this you need to conclude, and once you conclude, you can write down your findings and even you can share it with your friends. Okay, students, so this is regarding this whole lesson that is at the science fair. I hope so you have understood it very well, and you know, with lot of interest you might you know, read this lesson well, and you also have come to know that how a science fair has been organized or is organized. Okay, you can also, whenever there is science fair in your school, you can also help or volunteer to put up the science fair or the exhibition or the stalls, right, students? Yes. Now what I want you all to do is that write the meanings of the difficult words. This is one. Second, you need to try to find out the answers which are given in your exercise on page number 80. Is that clear, students? So this is all regarding the lesson at the science fair. So thank you, dear students. Thank you.